It is said that cats have 9 lives. If so, there has been one very lucky in history which used just a few of his. The black and white cat was originally named Oscar, but then became known as Unsinkable Sam. He started his career in the fleet of the Nazi regime, the Kriegsmarine, and ended it in the Royal Navy. He was on board Bismarck, the HMS Cossack, and the HMS Ark Royal, but here comes the cool part. While all those 3 ships sank, Sam survived them all. During World War II, many cats became known for their service on ships, and the role of a ship's cat was a position officially recognized by several navies. The main purpose of having these pets on board was mainly to fight against rodents, since rats created trouble for the crew and even carried germs that caused the plague. And rodents were one reason for the prevalence of cats aboard, but not the main one. They provided companionship and served as a good luck charm for the crew and their ship and helped to relieve stress. What made this pet become more famous than its colleagues by earning it the nickname Unsinkable Sam? During his experience in the Navy, he survived the sinking of 3 different ships. The military career of Unsinkable Sam began in 1941. He was about 2 years old when one of the sailors of the German Nazi battleship Bismarck carried him aboard. At the time, his name was Oscar. He had short black and white hair and lively eyes. During its first and last journey, the Bismarck was sunk in the open sea after a long hunt and an intense cannonade by the British Navy. On the 27th of May, only 115 sailors out of more than 2,200 embarked survived the sinking. The cat was found hours later floating on a board. He had survived by clawing a wooden grating. He was picked up from the water and rescued by the crew of the destroyer HMS Cossack, being the only survivor to be rescued by the homeward-bound British destroyer HMS Cossack, who then adopted him. At the time, the cat's name was unknown, so the crew decided to call him Oscar. This little pet switched sides from the Nazis to the Allied forces. Then, sadly, history repeats itself. Oscar served on board the Cossack for a few months, during which the ship was used as an escort unit in the Mediterranean and North Atlantic. On the 24th of October 1941, the Cossack left Gibraltar to escort a convoy to the United Kingdom and was torpedoed by the German submarine U-563. Struck by a torpedo, it suffered serious damage that compromised its stability. The bow had been damaged for about a third of the length of the ship, causing 159 victims amongst 190 total crew. The destroyer HMS Legion tried to tow the damaged ship, however, a worsening of the weather conditions made the attempt fail. Then the crew, including Oscar, was rescued by the Legion while the Cossack sank October 27th off Gibraltar. The cat survived again. He was found clinging to a piece of plank floating on the sea. When British officers were told what Oscar had been through, they decided that the nickname Unsinkable Sam was much more appropriate for such a lucky pet. However, Sam hadn't even had time to settle into the new ship that misfortune knocked at his door again. A few months later, Sam took service on the HMS Ark Royal aircraft carrier, which at that time was looking for a cat as an anti-mouse aid. On a return trip from the central Mediterranean, where the carrier had launched reinforcement planes to Malta, the HMS Ark Royal was torpedoed by the U-81 submarine on November 14, 1941. Every attempt to pull the wreck failed because of the enormous leaks from which the sea entered. The ship capsized 30 miles from the coast of Gibraltar. The sinking was slow enough to allow the rescue of the entire crew, with the exception of one man. Unsinkable Sam was rescued from the water by the crew of the HMS Legion. He was clinging to a floating artifact of a destroyed lance. Oscar was described by the crew as unharmed but angry. He had survived the violent sinking of 3 warships in less than 1 year. After the umpteenth sinking, Oscar found a home in the offices of the governor of Gibraltar, who thought Sam had been through too much to serve as a ship's cat again. It was time for him to retire. He was then repatriated to the United Kingdom, where he received room and board in the House for Sailors in Belfast. Happy to live far from the sea for the rest of his life, this was his home until his death of natural causes in 1955. During his lifetime, Unsinkable Sam became famous. He is remembered in photos from the British ships on which he served, as well as in a pastel portrait titled Oscar, the Bismarck's Cat, by the artist Georgina Shaw Baker, exposed at the National Maritime Museum in Greenwich. Some people question the veracity of Sam's story, classing it as a sea story. Surviving the Bismarck sinking seems especially unlikely, as salvaging the crew was done in desperate conditions. Even so, I could easily imagine a British soldier taking the time to save the cat. We don't know if the story is true or not, but we'll just take it as it is for now. Take it as you wish, as a legend or a myth or the plain reality. The story checks out as much as any story of this type could check out. Oh, and as for Sam's legacy, it goes to show that even in the most dire of circumstances, even as everything around you is crumbling down, you can still cling on to a piece of wood, get rescued, and move on to another ship and start over again. Or it goes to show that cats really do have 9 lives, all of which are absolutely worth living.